Hello, this is Bern, and if you know you're an introvert and have told yourself that part of the reason you're not finding love is your personality type, in today's video I'm going to demolish that myth and share why introversion can be your superpower and what you need to focus on and do to attract love much faster as an introvert. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to another edition of BernMendez.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, and heart-centered women how you can attract the man you want and enter the relationship you crave without the need for gimmicks, manipulation, or silly techniques. If this is your first time here and you want to thrive in love, make sure you hit the subscribe button so you can be notified of new episodes as they come out. Now, the first thing I'll share with you, if you're an introvert and you've been suffering as a result of not putting yourself out there too much or feeling that sense of overwhelm in what it takes to not just put yourself out there, but create lots of connections with men, I need for you to take a deep breath and understand that there's two things you have that men really want. First one is depth, your capacity to go deeper. And second one is your capacity to have empathy. If you understand that and can play it up, then you can get what you want. As someone who suffered through being an introvert and for a long time in my life, had a really tough time attracting love into my life, I can share with you that it's absolutely possible not just to share and express yourself as an introvert, but it's very possible to thrive in love. Now, before I share with you several points that you can apply immediately to start taking your love life to the next level, I'd like to share that if you want to go deeper than I can share on this video and understand how you can go beyond intellect and start embodying this change, then if you hit the first link on the description of this video, you're gonna find a free training that I created for you. All you have to do is click on that link. You'll see a page that looks like this. Enter your name and email, and you can start watching my free training right away. Now, step number one for you to thrive as an introvert and make it your superpower is understand you're not for everyone. It's okay to be selective. You are not looking to connect with someone who's the life of the party necessarily. You're not need to connect with someone who needs that type of social, heavy social interaction, because if you do, you're gonna suffer. Now, I'm not asking you to exclusively connect with an introvert. You wanna connect with someone who has the balance, right, of maybe connecting with you and feeling you deeply and having time alone and someone who enjoys connecting with others. But if you connect with someone who mostly enjoys connecting with others, then the rocky road that you're about to embark on may not be worth the trip. Number two, I need you to focus on depth versus breadth. Here's what I mean. One way of connecting with your ideal guy is to make hundreds of connections and by nature of just the law of numbers, find someone who's good for you. It's unlikely that you will do that. So what I want you to focus on is going the distance as deep as you can within reason, within the interactions that you create. Now, I will advocate for more connections because that just ups your numbers. But you don't have to go on hundreds of dates and connect with hundreds of men to find your ideal guy, so long as you have the capacity to be deeper and to be more present and to be more nuanced with every interaction that you have. One of the things that I want you to focus on is the art of holding space for someone. Here's something that for all the power and all the fanfare that extroverts get, they typically don't have the capacity to do is be very present with someone. Hold the space to where you can really see and feel someone. The moment you see and feel a man, if he is of the right type for you, he's gonna feel something hitting him in the chest that's going to allow you to stand out and rise to the top versus someone who's fun and someone who's the life of the party but may not have the capacity to hold that space that you have cultivated that capacity through your entire life. Number three, I need you to master the art of asking better questions. Why? Because if you master the art of asking better questions, every interaction that you focus on, depth versus breadth, you will stand out even more. You'll be more interesting. You'll have a better time. Instead of focusing on the anxiety of what are they thinking about me and do they like me, are they accepting me, you focus on being curious and hungry for what they're sharing. Ask better questions. That will lead to a much more interesting conversation and deeper knowing of someone in a faster amount of time. Step number four is I need you to recognize that sometimes in life you have to choose the lesser of two pains. right? You might be erroneously thinking that option number one is putting yourself out there more. Option number two is a comfortable massage watching Netflix. Well, if those are the choices, comfortable massage watching Netflix for an introvert is the thing to do. But if you focus on two things, challenge number one is putting yourself out there, creating more connections. Challenge number two is dying with your music inside of you, dying unseen, unfelt, unexpressed. Then if that's what's at stake, then that will punch you stronger in the stomach, and you won't just do it to find a boyfriend or catch a husband. You'll do it because you want to lead the type of life that allows you to die given at the end of your life, that allows you to play that music that's inside of you through your instrument, which is you. Number five, I want for you to change the outcome from just creating lots of connections to creating more moments of depth. Why? Because if you focus on creating moments of depth, if you focus on creating moments of presence, then that's something you already know how to do. You are a master at doing that. All I need you to do is focus on that versus all the other noise in your head when you connect with men. If you're saying, my outcome right now is creating a moment of depth, a moment of joy, a moment of self-expression with this person, and more, you will play up your strengths instead of focusing on what you don't have. Number six, I need you to play this game with yourself. I need you to focus on one person at a time. Here's what I mean. If you're about to go out there, and part of the reason you don't want to go out there is because you don't want to connect with groups of people. You don't want to connect with a place in a place where there's going to be like tons of guys in one setting, in one maybe social setting even. What you want to do is say, in the midst of a social setting, I can create one-on-one connection. So you could be in a room with 10 guys all sitting in a couch in front of you. So long as you focus on one person at a time, one conversation at a time with one human being, you will thrive. And you can switch, you can churn, you can connect with somebody else after 10 minutes or 20 minutes or whatever. But as long as you focus on that strong connection, one-on-one, you can be in groups of people and still enjoy it. Number seven, take more breaks. Sometimes your friends will go to a place where you stand a high chance of connecting with awesome men. And if the reason you're not going there is because you say, it's overwhelming, it's too long, and it's too many people, then part one is focusing on one-on-one. Part number two is taking more breaks, meaning instead of going with your friends and spending 6 hours in that place, go for an hour. You can do an hour of connecting with human beings in a group setting, one-on-one, you can do. Play that trick on your mind and see the difference it makes when you focus on it that way. Number eight, at the end of the day, you're gonna have to do things that are uncomfortable. You're gonna have to put yourself out there a little more. You're gonna have to ask questions that are tough. You're gonna have to share more of your heart, even if it's one-on-one. And I need you to understand that practicing discomfort is a spiritual practice. It's something that allows you to grow as a human being and evolve. You didn't come to this place called Earth to just have fun. You came here to evolve. And part of evolving is understanding that life will demand of you certain things, and you will grow in direct proportion of what life demands of you. And if you don't put yourself in challenging situations, life will demand less of you, which means you will not thrive as much. So understand that part of you asking questions, going to more meetings, connecting with more people, even if it's one-on-one, is growing spiritually. So go beyond the goal of, I want to catch a husband, and practice the goal of, I want to evolve and become the best version of myself, and this is just one way that will allow me to do that. Number nine is, for all the grief, all the pain, all the bad mouthing that online dating gets, if you're an introvert, you need to be using that tool to your advantage. And here's what I mean. If you hate going on meetups, if you hate going on social gatherings, if you hate going out and about on town with your friends, then as much as you need to do some of that, if you have a powerful online presence, you won't have to do as much. And what that means is that you need to redefine what online dating is. Part of the problem, if you don't like online dating, is because you have the false idea that maybe it should be 50-50. When you go online, 50% of the guys should be great, 50% of the guys should be a not fit. And what I'm sharing with you right now is that it's 98-2. 98% of the guys are not a fit, and 2% of the guys are a fit. Now, if you know this, and you go through 10 guys back-to-back who are not a fit for you, right? That's just like the law of numbers, right? You need to understand that it's okay. That's how it works. The thing is not broken. You just have to get more comfortable connecting with more people, swiping left and right with your index finger. It's not as bad as it seems. If you know how to play it upright, and if you have the right expectation from the start, which is 2% of the guys there is all you need. But if you think that it's a higher percentage that are fit for you, you'll be very frustrated early on and want to throw in the towel. And I don't recommend doing that. Hope this is helpful, useful, and insightful. As someone who's been an introvert my entire life, I can share with you that if you view this as an opportunity for you to grow as a human being, you will thrive. So if you enjoy this video and you want to go deeper, make sure to hit the first link in the description of this video so you can watch my free training that will help you to embody the changes instead of just intellectually understanding them. If you like the video, click like or thumbs up. If you subscribe to my channel, you'll be notified of new episodes as they come out by hitting the little bell. And last but not least, if you want to thrive in love and you've been watching videos, listening to audios and podcasts, and you've been doing the law of attraction, and you've been praying, and you've been getting shamanic cleanses, and nothing seems to be working, you might highly benefit from getting specific help from someone who knows. And if you think that might be me, click the second link in the description of this video so we can connect. You fill out an application, and if we're the right fit, we'll connect, and I can share with you how I might be able to get what you want in a fraction of the time. Hope you enjoy this. Thank you for allowing me into your home, into your heart. Drop me a line to let me know what you benefited from this most. And as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.